This video shows how to load prospects from the RedX into RealtyJuggler real estate software. The RedX is a lead service that provides expireds, FSBOs, and pre-foreclosure seller leads. RealtyJuggler is a customer relationship manager, CRM, for real estate agents and is the perfect complement to the RedX. The first thing I'll do is sign into my RedX account so I can export my leads. Next, I'll check off the leads I want to export. To the right of the checkboxes, at the top middle of the screen, I click Other, and then choose Export from the drop-down list. That will automatically begin the download process and save a file named vortex.csv to my Downloads folder. Now that my leads are downloaded, I'll go back to RealtyJuggler.com. I already have a RealtyJuggler free trial, so I'll sign into my RealtyJuggler account and click the Settings icon. Next, I'll click on the Import icon. I'll select the Prospects database, which is the database that I want to load my leads into. I'll set format to RedX, separated values, .csv. For duplicate records, I'll keep the setting of Not Imported. That way, any RedX leads that I've already imported into RealtyJuggler won't be duplicated. I can add a category to these new records so that I know that these are new ones. In my case, I'll add the categories of Call Now and RedX to make it easier to work with these fresh leads in RealtyJuggler. I'll enter both categories and separate them with a comma. I'll click here to select the vortex.csv file I downloaded from RedX, select it, and click on the Open button. Finally, I'll click the Import button to start the import process. My RedX records are now loaded into my RealtyJuggler Prospects database. I'll click back to Main Screen, and then click on the Prospects icon. Here are my leads. I'll filter these leads by selecting from the Show Category drop-down menu in the upper right corner of the screen. Since I added that category Call Now, I'll filter so I can see just those leads. These are my new leads. I'll click on one of these records to start making my phone calls. For example, I can call Alex here, and then add notes at the bottom of this screen regarding my conversation. I'll add a note about my conversation and add today's time and date. I'll schedule a follow-up call by using the Contact Again in XX Days field here. That way, all my scheduled follow-up calls will be displayed in my All Tasks screen, and I will know who I need to call and when. Next, I'll assign a drip print sequence. I'll do that by clicking on the Mail tab to the left, and then clicking the New Drip Mail button at the top. And I'll assign a time release sequence of letters. I'll change the media to print so that I can print my letters. If I wanted to email the letters instead, I could also do that. All I need to do is change the media to email. I'll select my prospect's name from the two drop-down menu. If I do that, and the record does not have an email address, RealtyJuggler will ask me if I would like to have my letters printed rather than emailed. I will say yes. I'll then select my drip group. In my case, I want Prospect Seller FSBO. That's a pretty good sequence of letters for sale by owner prospects. I'll click on the Create Drip Mails button, which will create my drip letters. I can see the letters are queued up in this list with the date and time that they are scheduled to go out. I can even preview one of the letters by clicking on a row. Now that I've made my final up call and assigned the drip sequence, I'm going to go back to the General tab and remove the category Call Now from that prospect record. That way, when I load more leads from RedX, only the new leads will show up if I filter the list by the category of Call Now. I just applied my drip sequence for one of my RedX leads. For the prospects list, I can click on the Next link in the upper left corner of the screen and repeat this same process for each of my new leads. This prospect has an email address, So I'll select a media of email. That way, these letters are not printed, but instead are automatically emailed. Now that I have assigned drip sequences to all of my RedX records, I can download a list of letters that I need to print for today. I'll do this by going to the main screen and clicking on the mail icon. Then, I will click on the Print Pending Mail icon. I can view the letters that need to be printed by clicking on the Unsent Mail tab at the top left of the screen. To download my letters, I'll click on the download link at the bottom of the screen. RealtyJuggler will then download my letters. To print those letters, all I need to do is open the downloaded file and open it using Microsoft Word. Additional information on how RealtyJuggler works can be found by going to the main screen and clicking on the YouTube video tutorials icon at the bottom of the screen. Here, you will find detailed instructions for how RealtyJuggler works. Video tutorial 21 shows you how the prospects database works and is an excellent video to start with. If you are interested in learning how to schedule follow-up calls, then we would recommend video tutorial 44. The touch cycle. Also, video tutorial 14 shows how to assign a drip sequence of emails or printed letters.